Yeah, we're here in Tarnal today with the young group of Bass who are currently living in Belfast, but they're also here to talk to Martine Anderson, the MEP, to explain and give the rationale of what work they do here in Belfast. They are here today obviously supporting their political prisoners who are spread right throughout Spain and elsewhere in the world, and obviously they're looking for repartition between their Bass prisoners. So it's about an awareness campaign. Martine Anderson works very closely with the Basque MEP out in Europe as well, so we know that work goes on. Martine was here to listen to him today and obviously give words of advice.
And we are also members of the Basque Solidarity Committee, and we would like to say thanks for your support and helping for the Basque political prisoners and the Basque movement in general in the European Parliament. The Sinn Féin has always helped and supported us, and this is very important in the Basque country. We also know that you have been a political prisoner and you were away from home, and you understand and you know the situation of the Basque political prisoners and their families. So only to say thanks and choquearla.
Now, look, I wish I could do more. I work away with...
After this, we're going into a meeting to discuss political ex-prisoners here on this island. So we're meeting with the Cuisha Network today, and obviously Martine will be taking some of their concerns on board about future funding opportunities, but also working closely with ex-prisoners and ex-prisoners' families. So it's great to have Martine in the constituency today. After this, we're heading up to meet supported homes as well in West Belfast. So we're meeting a number of groups and old age pensioners places as well this afternoon and this evening. So it's a long day for us. She's only back from North Belfast and travelled all around the north. So she's a very busy MEP, but very good on the streets, very good at campaigning, and she always gets her campaigns to a successful outcome.
Well, we had a very good meeting there with Martine concerning issues relating to the upcoming Peace Force funding coming from Europe to Ireland. Peace funding has been excellent for the work which has been carried out under the auspices of the Cuisha Network throughout the country. We have 12 offices, they're very difficult to maintain, but the funding which we get through Europe is excellent for the services which we provide. We cater for training, retraining, educational bursaries, family support for the political ex-prisoner community. Martine has been very, very useful to us, as has Paul, in using their influence both in Europe and over with the Westminster government over in England, in trying to bring forward the Republican narrative for what has happened here and for inclusion of the political ex-prisoner community in any funding coming through from Europe. They've been great advantage to us, we very much appreciate it, and what we were doing today was outlining with Martine the issues which are relevant just at the present moment in time with the threat of withdrawal of European funding to us. Martine, particularly as one of the Sinn Féin MEPs now over in Europe, is to she has undertaken to do what she can over with the European Commissioner for Regional Affairs in order to try and influence the funding to ensure the inclusion of the political ex-prisoner community in that funding.
Well, I started off in Stormont, and we've been engaging with a number of groups and organisations who are very concerned about the European Social Fund. And following that meeting of 25 groups, I had a meeting with hopefully future MP Gerry Kelly. And I then left Gerry Kelly and I went to North Belfast, and I was dealing with a group in North Belfast that had big concerns about fracking. We also went next door because there's a great cultural centre next door to the Sinn Féin office in North Belfast, and engaging with them, particularly about the role that Leah Nivida is playing in Europe around promoting Irish language, culture, arts and dance and song, and obviously the language is crucially important. So coming over to the West and being with Paul Maskey, who is a workaholic, as everybody would know, and drives you all around the city, but it was great to come in here to Tarnal today to meet with people from the Basque country who is raising the whole profile of their prisoners. And as a former prisoner myself, I understand the importance of particularly repatriation and the need for those prisoners to be located in prisons near their home, and obviously, but more importantly than that, is the whole issue of the peace process and the importance that prisoners pay in consolidating the peace. So it was apt that after that meeting that I was dealing with a number of former prisoners here who have been doing sterling work across not just Belfast but across this island in working to bring about the peace that we need, consolidating that and building on the reconciliation. And as we all all recognise the need for reconciliation is still there with us. We have a journey to travel. We're on a positive way forward. We're on a good path. But the former prisoners have got a sterling, they're doing sterling work, and they've got a very crucial role to play in building and consolidating not just the peace, but bringing all the traditions together. So this is what we do, and this is what we do best as people who are working together to not just bring you to Europe, but bring Europe to you. So therefore, next week we are bringing a number of people from across this island out to deal with equality and human rights issues, and obviously the former prisoners will be included in meetings that we will be arranging throughout that delegation, so that their needs can be put on the table and that they can be recognised and valued for the role that they have played in our society and continue to play.